remember all that was lost. We must take stock of the work being done on recovery while preparing for future disasters.
It won't be too long before the stock the Treasury is holding in GM can be sold, helping to reimburse the American people for their investment.
What we can't afford to do, though, is privatize Social Security, an ill-conceived idea that would add trillions of dollars to our budget deficit while tying your benefits to the whims of Wall Street traders and the ups and downs of the stock market. So this Labor Day, we should recommit ourselves to our time-honored values and to this fundamental truth. To heal our economy, we need more than a healthy stock market. We need bustling main streets and a growing, thriving middle class. And just as folks have done in every Thanksgiving since the first, we'll spend some time taking stock of what we're thankful for: the God-given bounty of America and the blessings of one another. The stock market and millions of American retirement accounts were in free fall. Our stock market has rebounded because even though corporate profits and the stock market have hit all-time highs, the typical family isn't bringing home more than they did 15 years ago. And since I took office, the stock market has more than doubled, replenishing the 401ks of millions of families. But while the stock market has more than doubled, restoring the retirement savings of millions, corporate profits are up, lending to businesses is up, and the stock market has hit an all-time high. Instead of taking so much stock in GM, we could have simply offered the company more loans.
You know, it is not every day that we have a championship stock car parked out in the South Lawn.
Our plan would put the cost of a firm's failures on those who own its stock and loaned it money.
And if we want an economy where our stock market's not only rising again, but our businesses are hiring again, and people's incomes are going up again,
it led to a situation in which folks with the most to lose, stock and pension holders, had the least to say in the process.
Today, President Obama and I took stock of progress in this vital year.